Hey, what up, everybody? This is Jayton Gunter, owner of Grapes and Sand Publishing. As you can see, there's wine in my glass. Happy Wine Wednesday. We're definitely going to be doing a wine review with you guys today. Very much looking forward to breaking down this wine from one of my favorite producers in Northern America. But before I get to that, I just want to let you guys know that if you have not checked out the video, I did a live with the regular wine guy, Sean Brady. You know, we have our show, Total Winos, that we kind of do deep dive educational stuff about wine. And this one was really cool because we actually did a thing where we did a bargain or bust. It's on YouTube. I posted it to Facebook, but it's bargain or bust. And he did a rosé and I did a white. We basically try to find wines that are at a reasonable price, but we want to see if it actually, like, it's punching above its weight class. So it's actually better. It's actually a really good bargain for the price. Or if it's really actually lower than the price, even though it's at a good, at a solid price. So I know I just said price a bunch of times, but you get what I'm talking about. So go check that out. Again, you just go to Total Winos on YouTube, or you can go to Total Winos on Facebook. And I will be taking pieces of it and putting it on Instagram too. So just a heads up. So go check that out. Also, for people who've been rocking with me thus far, thank you so much. I really appreciate your time, your patience. I appreciate everything you've done with supporting me and my comments and all that stuff. And then also people who are brand new to my channel, feel free to hit me up in the comments if you have any wine questions. Hit me up in the DMs. I'm always here for wine questions. Whether it's just you're at a store and you're ordering, you're figuring out like a meal and you want to figure out what wine, you can always message me. And if I'm around or available, I'll send you some good options for you. So just remember that. Anyway, you're not here for me to yap. You want to hear about the wine. So today, again, one of my favorite producers in Northern California. We are in Susan Valley with the Susan Valley Susan Wine Co-op over there. And we're talking about Sunset Cellars. And this is their Dry Creek Petite Sirah 2014. So this has a little age on it. Let's get right into it. They've made a bunch of wines that I love. They had a Syrah that I used to love by Sunset. They have a Malbec that they're pouring over there. That's amazing. But this, I saw this, I tasted it, and I was like, I really want to do a review on this. So let's get right into it. On the nose. So I get cassis. I get a little, some chocolate notes, a little bit of pencil lead going on here too. Some perfectly ripe plum. Actually whole plum with some skin, so it has like a kind of like a tart plum skin thing going on too. There's also some coffee grounds here too. Some burnt caramel. And a hint of flintiness as a secondary. This is very complex on the nose, which is why I gravitated towards this wine. Let's get into the palate. Let's see what's going on with the palate. Wow. It's just velvet. It's velvet on your palate. It's a rich up front. Has enough acid on the finish. I mean, it's not acidic at all. It's not overly acidic at all. It's probably medium acid. But it has enough acid to kind of balance out the richness of the fruit up front. I mean, you're getting some of those chocolate notes. You're getting some like cassis. You're getting some coffee grounds there. It's like this, the plum is hitting more in the third quarter to the finish. You're getting a little bit of like kind of a black raspberry up top too, up front. There's also like kind of this wet soil kicking in the third quarter too. So there's some earthiness in the mid palate to the third quarter. This is a very complex wine. This is a very good wine. This is if you're a Cabernet Sauvignon lover, this wine falls in your wheelhouse if you're looking for something at a steal for the price, and also that kind of gives you that kind of that weightiness that you're looking for. This is a very, very good steak wine. I'm telling you right now, this would kill steak. ribeye would be. This would be right up the alley with a rib, good ribeye. Yeah, this is delicious. I highly recommend it. Cool thing about Sunset Valley, or Sunset Cellars, is that their wines are always reasonably priced. I believe this is like under $30, if I'm not mistaken, at a place that's like right there in wine country. And it's under $30 for something, for this kind of experience. Highly recommend this. Go pick up a bottle. Go check out the Susan. I'll put a link in there, but check out the Susan Wine Co-op, Susan City Wine Co-op over there in Susan City. This is outstanding wine. I highly recommend it. Let me see. Question of the day. I don't hear a lot about Petite Sirah from people. If you've had Petite Sirah, what is your favorite Petite Sirah in California? I am very curious about that. I've had a couple of them that I really like, but Sean Thackeray is one that I used to really, really love back in the day. I'm curious of what you guys have. Till next time, guys. Cheers. So while editing the video for... the wine's got a chance to open up, and I'm catching now, like, pepper that's jumping out of the glass at me. I'm also getting a lavender note, like lavender flowers. Also a little bit like of cured meat, maybe like pepper beef jerky as a secondary, and a little bit of baking spice. Kind of interesting. I did not expect that, and when I tasted it, you don't get the baking spice so much, but you definitely get that pepper and a little bit of kind of like an irony, beef jerky on the finish. So cheers, guys.